Hi friends, today let us deal with an exciting topic called isoenzymes. And in the isoenzymes, in particular, we are going to deal with lactate dehydrogenase. Let's go ahead. The isoenzymes were first described by Hunter and Clement in the 1957. Let's go to the definition of isoenzymes. These are the enzymes that differ in the amino acid sequence, but they catalyze the same reaction. Understand here, they catalyze the same reaction. There are many forms of the enzyme, but they differ in the amino acid sequence also. All of them, though they are many enzymes, but they catalyze only same reaction. They are also called as multiple forms of the enzymes. Isoenzymes are also called as isoforms because they are closely related variants of the enzymes. They may be located in different tissues, but they catalyze the same reaction. And these are encoded by homologous genes that have diverged over the time. Let's go to the properties of isoenzymes. As we have already seen that they are called as multiple forms of the enzyme. There may be 2, 3, 4, 5 enzymes. All of them catalyze the same reaction, but they differ. Where they differ? They differ in the structure, they differ in the electrophoretic mobility, they differ in the immunological properties, they differ in the Km values and Vmax values, they also differ in the optimum pH. And relatively, they differ to the inhibitors and degree of denaturation. What is Km here? Km is Michaelis-Menten constant. Overall, we can say that they differ in the physical and chemical properties. Though they are catalyzing the same reaction, they differ in many of the physical and chemical properties. They are synthesized from different genes, we have seen. Example, malate dehydrogenase is present both in the cytoplasm as well as in the mitochondria. But the cytosolic malate dehydrogenase is formed from one gene and the mitochondrial malate dehydrogenase is formed from another gene. And usually these isoenzymes are oligomeric in nature. What is meant by oligomeric? Oligo here means few. Mer means units. They contain few units, more than one type of subunits are present. Okay, example to say the isoenzymes are lactate dehydrogenase, malate dehydrogenase, creatine phosphokinase are some of the examples of isoenzymes. With this introduction, let's go to our topic for today, which is lactate dehydrogenase, which is the best example for the isoenzymes. It is shortly called as LDH, lactate dehydrogenase. The specific name or systematic name is L-lactate NAD plus oxidoreductase. And the enzyme commission number is 1.1.1.27. What this LDH catalyzes? It catalyzes the interconversion of lactate to pyruvate. It converts lactic acid to pyruvic acid, and at the same time it catalyzes the reverse reaction also. So there is reversible arrow. Remember, it converts the conversion of it converts pyruvic acid to lactic acid, likewise lactic acid to pyruvic acid. And this is the reaction catalyzed by the lactate dehydrogenase. Lactic acid on oxidation undergoes pyruvic acid. Pyruvic acid on reduction goes, it forms the lactic acid. Let's see the different forms, different isoenzymes of LDH. LDH isoenzymes, there are five distinct isoenzymes. What are they? LDH1, LDH2, LDH3, LDH4, and LDH5. And as I told you, they differ in the physical and chemical properties, and they can be separated by electrophoresis. LDH1 is more positively charged LDH5 is less positively charged. So it is more positively charged. That is why it is acidic in nature. And LDH5 is more basic in nature. In the electrophoresis, during the electrophoresis, what is electrophoresis? There are two electrodes that are present. One is the positive electrode, another one is negative electrode. Between them, if the LDH1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are moving, here LDH1 moves very faster because it is more positively charged. It is attracted to the negative electrode very fastly. That is the electrophoretic mobility, and these are the isoforms. That means isoenzymes are LDH. What are they? LDH 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Let's move on to the structure in detail. These are oligomeric enzymes. Oligomeric means, as I mentioned earlier, they contain more than one polypeptide chain. Here LDH contains four polypeptide chains. That is why it is called as tetrameric in nature. And it is made of two different types of subunits. Remember, all the LDH enzymes, they contain four subunits, but among the subunits they may be either M subunit or H subunit. Okay, M stands for muscle, H stands for heart, and these are produced from different genes. M subunit is more basic, H subunit is acidic. And this LDH, they contain either one or both the subunits, giving rise to LDH 1 to 5. In the LDH 1 to 5, M and H subunits are present in different ratios. Let's see how they are present. Here, you can understand it very well. It contains two subunits. What are the two subunits? One is the H subunit, the green one is a H subunit, and the pink one is M subunit. Two types of subunits are making LDH, LDH 1 to 5. In the LDH 1, only H subunits are present. Remember, all LDH are tetrameric in nature. They contain how many subunits? All of them contain four subunits, but they contain M subunits and H subunits depending on the tissue in which it is present. LDH1 is made of entirely H subunits. LDH2 contains one M subunit, three H subunits. LDH3 is made of two H and two M subunits. LDH4 is made of three M subunits and only one H subunit. LDH5 is made of all the four M subunits only, M polypeptide chains. And likewise, where they are located, this is the location. Where they are located, LDH1 is located in the heart and RBC. LDH1 and 2 is located in heart and RBC. LDH3 is located in brain and kidney. LDH4 and 5, they are located in the liver and skeletal muscle. And coming to this red one is nothing but electrophoretic mobility. As I told you, LDH1, that means H subunit is acidic. H subunit is acidic. Acidic means what? It contains more positive charge. That is why it moves fastest in the electrophoresis, during electrophoresis. Likewise, the electrophoretic mobility is going on decreasing. LDH5, it moves very slowly compared to all the other LDH isoenzymes. Why it moves very slowly? Because M subunit is more basic. More basic means it contains very less positive charge, whereas LDH1 is acidic. It contains much of the positive charge. That is why it moves fastest. LDH5 moves very slow. And remember, this image is that you can write the gist just by seeing the image. You can see the subunits, the composition of subunits, the location in different tissues, and electrophoretic mobilities. Okay, we have seen the structure. Let's move on to the significance of lactate dehydrogenase. LDH1, let's see LDH1. LDH1 means it is acidic because it contains much positive charge. It is made of all the four subunits, which are nothing but H polypeptide chain only. Okay, and LDH1, it is predominantly present in the heart muscle. We have seen that LDH1 and 2 are present in the heart and RBC. It is present in the heart muscle and it is inhibited by pyruvate. What is pyruvate here? The substrate. Usually pyruvic acid is converted into lactic acid. Depending on the need, lactic acid is also converted into pyruvic acid. But here in the heart muscle, what is happening? The LDH1, which is present in the heart muscle, is inhibited by the pyruvate. That means whenever there is much pyruvate, this lactate dehydrogenase enzyme does not work. That means this reaction does not take place whenever there is excess amount of the pyruvate. Hence, pyruvate is not converted into lactic acid in the cardiac muscle. But this pyruvic acid, it is converted into what it is converted? It is converted into acetyl coenzyme A, acetyl CoA. What is acetyl CoA? Where it enters? Acetyl CoA enters into the TCA cycle. What is TCA cycle? It is citric acid cycle, central for the metabolic reactions, where using this ATP, much amount of the ATP is created using the when the pyruvic acid enters into the citric acid cycle via acetyl CoA. Okay, did you understand? Okay, that is why LDH1 has high KM for pyruvate. KM means what? KM is the Michaelis-Menten constant, which indicates affinity of an enzyme to the substrate. Remember, KM is nothing but affinity of an enzyme to the substrate. If it has a high KM, means it has a low affinity for the substrate. Okay, so this LDH1 is having high KM, means what? It is having low affinity with the substrate. It is having low affinity with the substrate. That is why it is not converted into lactic acid. Okay, it is inhibited by the pyruvic acid, and this pyruvic acid, it is used in another reaction. It is converted into acetyl coenzyme A, and which enters into TCA cycle. This is about LDH1 importance. Let's see the importance or significance of LDH5. Where is LDH5 present? It is present in the skeletal muscle, usually liver and skeletal muscle, and it is entirely made of M subunits. And this inhibition of this enzyme by pyruvate is minimal. That means even though pyruvic acid is present, this enzyme is not inhibited. If the LDH is not inhibited, means what happens? The pyruvic acid is converted into lactic acid. That is the meaning. Hence, pyruvate is converted into lactic acid. And this LDH5 has low KM. Low KM means what? High affinity. High affinity towards what? High affinity to the substrate, high affinity to the pyruvate. This LDH5 has high affinity to the pyruvate. That is why whenever pyruvate is available, what happens? Whenever pyruvate is accumulated, it is converted into lactic acid. See here, you can see the difference between LDH1 and LDH5. Both are catalyzing a different reaction. Both are opposite. Okay, the LDH1, it is not allowing the formation of lactic acid in the heart, whereas LDH5, it is allowing the formation of the lactic acid. There is differential catalytic activities in the heart and the liver, heart and the skeletal muscle. Why there is a difference? Because of the conditions. What are the conditions? Heart means full of aerobic condition, presence of much oxygen, and the skeletal muscle is absence of oxygen, or anaerobic conditions may be prevailing in the tissues. When there are anaerobic conditions prevailing, whenever we are exercising, whenever we are doing some work, what happens in the skeletal muscle? There is less amount of the oxygen which is present. So during hypoxia conditions or during the absence of the oxygen, what happens? The pyruvic acid, instead of going into the TCA cycle, it enters into the lactic acid to give some of the immediate energy. Okay, That is the significance. Let's move on to the diagnostic importance of LDH. In the diagnostic centers also, the serum is collected from the individuals and the LDH levels, the LDH 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 levels are estimated because they are very, very important. The normal serum level, see here this diagram, the normal serum levels, usually this is the pattern of normal LDH levels. 1, 2 is always higher than the 1. Remember, 2 is always higher than other LDH isoforms where in the normal individual. Okay, in the healthy individual, activity of LDH2 is higher than that of LDH1. But during myocardial infarction or during heart attacks, what happens? LDH1 is much greater than LDH2. Okay, see, this is the LDH pattern of the myocardial infarction. What happens? LDH1 is usually very low. See this figure, first figure. And coming to the during the heart attacks, what happens? The LDH level, LDH1 is increased so many times within the 12 to 24 hours of the heart attack. So this is the diagnostic importance of LDH1. And there is increased LDH5 in the serum, which indicates liver diseases. See, this is the liver disease pattern of the LDH5. LDH5 is very, very high compared to other enzymes. The normal individual, LDH2 is higher. During heart attacks, LDH1 is very higher. And during liver diseases, in case of liver diseases, what happens? LDH5 is much higher. Where? In the serum, not in the blood, remember. And remember why I'm stressing not in the blood means LDH activity in the RBC is 80 to 100 times more than that of in the serum. That is why during the estimation of LDH isoenzymes, the serum should be totally free from the hemolysis. That means it should be totally free from the RBC. Only serum has to be taken. Serum has to be prepared with utmost care. Otherwise, we get the false positive results. This is about LDH. Let's sum up once again. Isoenzymes are multiple forms of the enzymes. They differ in physical and chemical properties. They are usually oligomeric. For example, in the LDH, it contains 4 subunits, tetrameric. Example for isoenzymes are malate dehydrogenase, lactate dehydrogenase, and creatine phosphokinase. Coming to the LDH, it catalyzes the interconversion of lactate to pyruvate. Lactic acid is converted to pyruvate, pyruvic acid is converted into lactic acid. Made of 5 isoenzymes are there, LDH 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And these 5 isoenzymes, they are made of only 2 types of subunits. What are they? Either M subunit and H subunit, or mixing both the M subunit and H subunit. We have seen that LDH 3, it contains 2 H subunits and 2 M subunits. Okay, and LDH5, coming to the LDH5 significance, it is mostly found in the heart muscle. In the heart muscle, there is aerobic environment. That is why it is inhibited by the pyruvate. This reaction does not take place. Which reaction? Conversion of pyruvic acid to lactic acid does not take place in the heart muscle. That's why the LDH has to be inhibited. Okay, and the pyruvate is converted into acetyl-CoA. Acetyl-CoA enters citric acid cycle, aerobic respiration takes place. But LDH5 does opposite reaction. LDH5 is abundantly present in the skeletal muscle and it is not inhibited by the pyruvate. Though pyruvate is present in much quantity, it is not inhibited. The pyruvate is converted into lactic acid. Let's go to the diagnostic importance. High LDH1 than that of LDH2 indicates heart attacks, myocardial infarction, recent myocardial infarction. And high LDH5, what it indicates? It indicates the liver diseases. We have seen the definition of isoenzymes, different examples of isoenzymes, the structure, function, and diagnostic importance of LDH, lactate dehydrogenase. Thanks for watching. Watch more videos in the subject.